All right, fighting for you for over 40 years. Welcome, Marco Bacciarelli. He is the managing partner at Friedman, Domiano and Smith. Thank you for coming in today.
It's my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
You were a lot less scary than my last guest, I will say.
Shorter, less impressive. It's a whole thing.
No, it's good to have you here. Today we are talking about alternative dispute resolution.
That's right. Yeah.
So what is that technically, first of all, before we get into more questions?
Sure. So just as a brief introduction, when you call us at Friedman, Domiano and Smith, every case that we take, we're always preparing as if we're going to trial. OK, and that's the best way to maybe get something done before you have to go to trial. Mm-hmm. Alternative dispute resolution is a kind of in-between step to say, do we have to go through this process? Do we actually have to go to trial? Maybe is there an opportunity to get this resolved without all the cost and expense and life struggle of going through a lengthy trial?
So there's clearly a lot of different areas where it affects your life by going through the trial. Financially,
sure.
Yes. And then I'm sure that just if you've gone through something that is traumatic or something that is bothersome, having to relive it through a whole trial can be very difficult for
Absolutely.
People as well.
Yeah, so there are certainly a lot of advantages to engaging in some kind of alternative dispute resolution to going to trial. The first one being preparing for a trial. Going to trial is a costly endeavor. It can mm-hmm. cost, you know, $5,000-$10,000. And my firm advances all those expenses, but eventually it has to be paid out of something. Also, just like you said, it is a harrowing experience. It's something that people aren't used to. So there are a couple of different forms of ADR or alternative dispute
okay.
resolution.
There is
a mediation
okay.
Where an independent third party comes in and will really just act between the two parties and act as a go-between and try to find a common ground. And then there is an arbitration. An arbitration is like a mini trial. There's usually a panel, maybe three attorneys or judges of varying backgrounds, and they will hear the case in a much more low stress, which is important, and
Absolutely.
Low cost environment, and they will give you a decision, and you can decide based upon that decision, do I think that's reasonable or do I think I need to go forward?
So what are then the advantages of going through maybe a mediation or arbitration?
And I already touched on some of these, but it is certainly a lot less stress.
Yes.
Overall, it is a much lower expense than going through a trial, and it is far less time consuming. If you have a case and we go to trial, you're looking at a minimum of 3 days sitting in a courtroom, and usually it's longer than that, right? An arbitration or a mediation, you're looking at half a day. So just kind of the investment across the board, if it's possible, is far less.
Are there disadvantages, though, to going this route in any way?
So I guess the disadvantage would be there is no way to force someone to be reasonable, right?
So you could, but yeah.
I do. The only way that I can force another person or another party to be reasonable is go to trial and get a verdict. And then a court of law says, this is what you are accountable for. In an arbitration or a mediation, if the other party is not going to be reasonable, if they're not going to see the logic of the benefits of this alternative path, then you can't force it down their throat, and then you're just kind of wasting your time.
So if someone feels that a suit is something that they should be doing, what is the best? I know they give you the initial phone call. What is the process going to be like for them to start things off?
So for us, there's a big information gathering phase, and once we get all that together, that's when I get a settlement demand out there. That's the point where we're engaging with the other side and trying to make a decision. Do we want to talk about this, or do we want to just forge ahead? Now, in any trial, in any litigation, even before you file and after, there are pit stops along the way, mm-hmm. and those pit stops are good opportunities to just have a reasonable conversation. And these arbitrations and mediations, those are situations where if the two parties can even agree to engage in it, then you get someone who is outside of both parties who is saying, this is what we think would be reasonable. And that's helpful, I think, for the people that I represent and for the people on the other side who have to look at it and go, okay, this isn't just one person. This is a completely outside person with no kind of dog in the fight who is saying, this is where we think we see this.
It's kind of like a therapist of sorts, right?
It's not unlike a therapist, yes. A couple's therapist, right?
Exactly.
There you go.
Exactly. You always have to have, and it's always good to have that alternative source that is not involved in any way. So, Marco, again, thank you for coming in. Friedman, Domiano, Smith, if you have any questions, you have concerns, you need to file a suit, these are the people to call. Serving
thank you so
for
much.
Over 40 years.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Have a wonderful early, happy Thanksgiving to you.
You too.